The topic we are going to discuss today is Autopilot, your partner for artificial intelligence at work. This would be our agenda. We are going to start with what exactly is an autopilot, what are the capabilities. I am going to showcase a quick demo of the autopilot in the studio web. We are going to see what could be the example prompts which we can utilize. And lastly, I am going to talk about what are the next steps you can have to continue your journey in the autopilot, right? So first thing first, what exactly is an autopilot? In October 2023, UiPath introduced something which is called UiPath Autopilot. It is an array of AI-driven experiences which is now integrated in the complete UiPath platform. And these experiences are not only restricted to the developer. Either you could be a business analyst, you could be a tester, or you could be just a simple user of automation. UiPath has something to offer for everybody. Right, and in the upcoming slides you would see that how the different personas can use the autopilot and what is there for everybody. Right, so to make it simple, autopilot is just a experience, AI driven experience, which is now integrated in the UiPath platform and it is available for all of us. If I talk about the autopilot capabilities specifically for the developers, it is available for the professional developers who are more into the coding and the citizen developers as well. You can use autopilot to create the automation, generate expression, write the codes as well. We have something which is called UiPath apps, right, which is also a product which is provided by UiPath. Autopilot is now available in UiPath apps where you can generate expression, build the automation, even creating automation powered applications from PDF or images, right? That's how powerful autopilot is being. Now, let's say if you are not a developer, what is there for you? In my UiPath assistant, I have something which is called Clipboard AI, which is doing my task of copying and pasting. Now, you might be thinking that I can always do it manually, right? What is so special about it? It has capability to do the copy and paste in a more intelligent way. And the best part, it can handle the complex data as well. Right, so it is not your traditional copy pasting, it is the Clipboard AI, which is an AI based tool to do the copy paste. If you are a tester, you have Autopilot for test suite. If you are a business analyst, you have Autopilot available for the process mining, where the business analyst can use the natural language to filter, summarize, create the dashboard for your automation opportunities. Right, so Autopilot is there for everybody. Talking more about the developers, what exactly is there for developers, right? This is the slide, you can read it, but to just quickly summarize, you can generate text to workflow. I have an automation idea, but I do not know what activity should I use. So this is specifically for the people who are using Studio Web. You can just write your automation and Autopilot will generate the automation for you. Let's say you are more experienced developer and you want to write some expressions, right? Autopilot can help you to convert your text to expressions. People who are coming from studio background might know that yes, we have something which is called coded automation. Autopilot is now capable of generating the automated code in your code base automation. This feature is released in 23.12 version of Studio Desktop Community, right? So this is what is all for developers. Now to get started with the Autopilot for Studio Web, all you have to do is you have to just log into cloud.uipath.com and you should log into your tenant. Once you are in the tenant, on the left hand side, you would have something which is this icon, which is called the Studio Web. Click on that and that should launch your web studio for you, right? When you log in the studio for the first time, these are the tabs you are going to see. You would have templates, project, automation, runs and connections. In the projects, you would see all the projects which you have already used. So it's not like that you are creating projects and they are getting loose, right? So all the projects would be available in the project tabs. In the template, you have something which UiPath has already created for you, which you can directly utilize, right? So let's say there are some of this available, such as if you want to convert the Word file to PDF and store into OneDrive, you can directly use it, right? So these are the templates which are available. You can search for the template by writing the description here. But where exactly is the copilot, right? So let's say there is an automation which is not available in the template. Now here you see something which is called a generate button. You can click on that button, and here it says describe an automation. Now this is where you have to just write your automation, whatever you have in the mind, in a plain text, right? So let's say newer is in the corner, right? So I'm writing an automation which says that whenever I receive an email, right? So I am using Office 365, so I'll use Office 365 that contains new year, right? So I want to write an automation that whenever somebody sends me a happy new year message, something, I want to immediately reply saying that happy new year 2024, right? Simple automation, but I don't know what activities, what automation should I write. So I'm just writing here, whenever I receive an email in Office 365 that contains new years in the subject, right, reply to that email with, let's say, happy new year to, let's say, happy new year 2024 from Mukeshkala, right? So that's what I wanted to reply. So this is a simple automation which I want to write, and I can just go here and I click on this button which says generate, right? Now till the time this automation is generating, you can use it something like this. Whenever there is a new row added to the Google Sheet, do this. If I have received a new email from this one, do this, right? If I have a new drive, new file which is available in Google Drive, you want to copy paste that file, you can do all of that, right? Once this is available, you can see that there is something which is called the workflow preview. It shows me that, hey Mukesh, this is what I have got. I can go at the bottom and I can click on this button which says continue in studio. Okay, and we are scaffolding your workflow. Once the automation is ready, you would see something like this, right? So you might be seeing that it has already used the Microsoft Office 365 connections. I am already connected to it. In case you are not connected, you can just go here and you would have a connect button. You just select your Office account, 365 account, and connect to it, right? You can also use the Google account as well. Now the next one was that we need to check. So it's saying that email.subject.contains new year, right? And then you can see here it is replying to that same email saying that happy new year 2024 from Mukeshkala, right? So this is our mailbox. We don't have any email. So I'll go to my Gmail. I'll try to write a new email to the mailbox saying happy new year, and I'll just send this. Now we'll just wait for the email to be received in this Outlook mailbox, because this is the Office 365 we have connected, and once the email is here, we'll go hit there and we'll trigger the automation. Okay, so we have the new email here. I'll go to my automation which is just generated, and before publishing, I'll just go here and I click on this button which is test, right? Now when you are testing the workflow, you can see on the right hand side that what the automation is doing, building the project, initializing, all the things which are happening in the project, you would be able to see. So this is the same, the logs, which are the steps which the automation is taking, right? So as you can see what is happening, this activity was successful. So you can see that this is ran successful, right? And automation completed, right? So now let's go back to the mailbox and see what has happened, right? So the first thing first, in the here you can see that this was the mail, and you could see that the automation has replied to this email saying that happy new year 2024 from Mukeshkala. That is what we have told the automation to do, right? In my Gmail also, you can see that this is the email which we have written, happy new year, and I have got a response from the email mukeshkala@outlook.com saying that happy new year 2024 from Mukeshkala, right? So this means that this was a simple automation which I was able to complete, right? Now the next, you can just click on this button and you can publish it to the orchestrator, and that would be available for you in your orchestrator, right? Also, one more thing, you can also submit this as a template to UiPath so that this appears on the first feed where all the templates were there. And in case while doing any of this, you find some difficulties, you can also provide feedback directly by clicking on this button, which is called the feedback. Okay, so that was a quick demo on how to use Studio Web for the workflow generation, right? So now these are some of the examples which you can try it on your own and see how does it behave, right? So for example, you can also use the prompt like, whenever I receive an email that is not in English, translate it and send it back to me, right? You can use this. Every Monday, read my to-do file from the OneDrive and send an email with the line marked as urgent. Every time I get a new lead created in the Salesforce, create a team message in this team channel with their name and the company, right? So all of these things, whichever you see on the screen, are the prompts which you can utilize, right? Now, please remember one thing, whenever you are trying to create any automation with Salesforce, Microsoft Teams, OpenAI, or let's say language translation, right? You have to connect to their integration services, right? Because UiPath does not know, right, which teams you are logging in, or let's say which OpenAI key you are using, right? So every time you generate a workflow, the workflow is going to prompt you to select your account, provide your credential, provide your API key. So please provide those and then you should be good to go. Similarly, for UI automation, you can do this. Studio Web, you can do that. For the studio, which is in the UiPath code studio, you can do something like this, right? Generate a random email address, generate a latest weather from weather.com, right? So all of these are some of the example for you to try on. Now, our questions. Do you want to know more about it? Where can I go and where can I find more about these things, right? Okay, so now to know more about it, you just go to forum.uipath.com and you would have a post which is called Autopilot for Developers. This post has got all the details to get started. It even has a video where the UiPath team is showing the hands-on demo of this feature, right? Please explore this. If you have questions, feedback, you can use this thread or you can also directly use the feedback button as well, right? So with that, I would like to wrap this video here. I hope this was insightful. If you have any more questions, any more doubts, feel free to write in the comments or you can also drop an email as well. So with that, I'll wrap this video here. Thank you for watching and happy automation.